Madre, do you find me attractive? I know I'm an old woman now, but do you?
Well, I don't, as you will know, I don't judge people by their physical attributes. It's the beauty of your soul that attracts me.
My soul?
Yes.
That is a brief look at The Madres, which is Teatro Vista's newest production. Cast member Lorena Diaz, who plays Carolina, the mother whose daughter has disappeared in the play, and director Ricardo Gutierrez are joining us now to talk a little bit about the show. Welcome to the both of you.
Thank you for having us.
Nice to have you. Looks like a fun one. Explain sort of the plot line to The Madres. And I don't know, do we go with La Madres or The Madres?
The Madres.
The Madres
is the official title. A play written by Stephanie Allison Walker, who is a former Chicagoan, now resides in Los Angeles, who lived several summers and a couple of years in Buenos Aires.
Okay.
And she was not familiar with this story, the story of the Madres who are protesting against the government to find their disappeared daughters, cousins, husbands, brothers. During the 1970s and into the 80s, and demanded to know where they disappeared. And unfortunately, up to about 30,000 of them were just never heard from again. And they're still marching as of today. They march every Thursday at 3:30, which is a pivotal plot line in the play. So it's a story about three generations, a grandmother, a mother, and a granddaughter. And I'll let Lorena tell about her story, because it spins
around her.
She's
got a bit of a connection to her.
It spins around her, yes.
Okay. Go ahead.
Well, it is a story of women and three generations of women, and one of them is disappeared, and we plot in a very I Love Lucy type manner.
I like it already.
To find it. It is there's a lot of humor in the play, but it definitely has some serious undertones and provocative happenings that I think the audiences will really chew on in a positive way.
What has the reception been like? Because it's been out, what, about a week or a little bit over a week. So what are people telling you about it? How are they reacting to it?
Well, first of all, everyone seems to resonate with the story, whether they have any connection to Venezuela, to Argentina or not, because it is a story of motherhood and the protection of your children. And it is a story that still goes on today. So the audiences have been reacting very loudly, a lot of tears, a lot of humor, because there is a lot of humor in this play, even though it's a horrific story. And there have been standing ovations after everyone, and people just standing around wanting to talk to the actors, and then also wanting to meet Yvonne Cole, who graces our stage as the matriarch of the family.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about the people who are in this show.
Yes.
Yeah. Lorena being one of them,
yes.
And I recognize her because I went to see the Dominisuelan, was that what it was?
That's right,
which is a great comedy show. You guys were fantastic.
Thank you.
And you've been in a number of other things as well that people at home may remember or recognize. So talk about your journey.
Well, I'd like to say that I was made in Chicago, because all of my good work has come out of here. Dominisuelan is a two-woman comedy show with two Latinas at the helm, things have gone very well for us. We're working with Fred Armisen right now from Portlandia to do the Dominisuelan Consulate, which is a fun, other awkward, fun show.
Okay.
And then currently I'm also playing the snarky Nurse Doris on Chicago Med. So that and this play keeps me quite busy.
Pretty busy, pretty busy. And we're expecting lots of other big things to come from you.
Well, so we've been wanting to get the Lorena on our stage at the Teatro Vista show with her and Wendy, her partner, and it just hasn't worked out. And so when this role opened up and it really, really connected with Lorena, I was over the moon when
I
she
bet.
Came in.
Which was good that he was over the moon, because I would have threatened his life for the part. So
she pretty much
luckily
said, this is my role, I'm demanding it. I said, well, show me. And I said, it's your role.
I love it. And another big name that we may recognize, Yvonne.
Yes.
So talk about her.
Yvonne Cole, who we saw on the clip that started this session, is a legend in Puerto Rico. She had a television show there in the 70s. She is a singer, she's a dancer, she's an actress. And she moved to the States in the 70s. Her first role, I think, was in The Godfather. And from there, it just boomed. And she has been an ensemble member with Teatro Visa for a number of years, 12, 13 years or so. But she hasn't been able to come back to us. She's been so busy. But this role, once again, attracted her, and it worked with her scheduling.
Lorena, you and Yvonne as well can attract so many people who are interested in their work to come and watch the wonderful productions put on by Teatro Visa. And I've actually seen myself how much the productions have grown,
yes.
I think,
yes.
in the last few years. Have you guys noticed that as well?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. There's an audience out there that's hungry for this kind of work, mm-hmm. and they're not just Latinos. They're all sorts of different faces in the crowd, and it's really, really wonderful to see it.
Good, good. Mm-hmm. Is there maybe the potential for this to stretch beyond the running time that you've got, or maybe take it to other houses?
Well, there's a possibility. I know that there are a couple other productions that are going to be presented this year of this particular play. That's how mm-hmm. popular it is. There's also a companion piece to this called The Abuelas,
okay.
because the fight for the mothers finding their children is still going on today. They still march today. And about a month ago, through DNA testing, of the children was found, mm-hmm. An adult now. But the government at that time in Argentina took the babies that were born and they gave them to military
families,
family members and all. Mm-hmm. And the children, unbeknownst to them, were adopted by them and raised. And so the fight for finding out where they are and demanding to know where they are is still going on.
Yeah,
today.
It's got to be incredible to be able to tell a story like
Amazing.
That for so
yeah.
many people that maybe don't know about it.
It's an incredibly,
yes.
incredibly mm-hmm. powerful story that speaks to everyone. And we will be presenting this story until May the 27th
okay.
at the Richard Christensen Theater in the Biograph. And for tickets, people can go to our website, teatrovista.org, and enjoy and be pierced by this story.
Yes.
All right, tell me about you and the work that you've got coming up after this.
Well, I am the executive artistic director with Teatro Vista, and I also work as an actor. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, I don't have the time to be on stage as
you
often as
everything.
I would like.
You can't do everything. I understand.
I've had to turn down some roles, but last year I was able to do some. And so I'm just now working to select our seasons. We're almost set, and we'll be announcing our season for next year very, very soon. So,
that's great.
That.
I love it. Teatro Vista really coming along and doing some wonderful work. Yeah. You guys should be really proud.
We are very, very proud. If I may quickly mention one final thing is that for everyone to come to see Yvonne on stage, but that we're also having a special Evening with Yvonne Cole that is going to be presented, I believe, May the 21st.
Okay.
Let me double check that date if I may.
All
right. I wrote it down.
May the 21st. In the meantime, I'll give people
May
the information.
May the 21st. Uh-huh. And teatrovista.org, they can come spend an evening with Yvonne Cole and get
I
to
love
know
it.
Her.
Okay. I love it. The information up on the screen one more time so that folks know Teatro Vista running The Madres until late May. So check it out. There's the info on the screen one more time.